Today we're going to learn how to test for accessibility using AxCore from DQ and Selenium WebdriverJS. This is a really great way to work accessibility into your development workflow and catch any regressions, benchmark the current level of accessibility support and make sure that it stays accessible. I have a handy demo for today on GitHub. It's github.com/marcysutton/ax-webdriverjs-demo. At this demo, you can see the requirements for today and you can fork it to get up and running with your own integration tests. We are going to run accessibility tests against eBay's accessibility pattern examples, which I have running locally on my machine. This demo is really great. It was created to show native HTML radio buttons, CSS radio buttons, and custom HTML radio buttons using aria. And these were built with accessibility in mind, so I don't anticipate really much in the way of accessibility problems at all, but I am curious what AX will find, if anything. And it's just a handy project to run some tests against. So to see what we need to do to get started, I have already checked out this demo and I am going to open up package.json. Some notable things in package.json, the scripts starting with post install. We're going to initialize Jasmine when we run npm install. And then we have an npm test command, which will run our tests against Jasmine, specifically the version of Jasmine in the node modules directory, as opposed to Jasmine installed globally. Our dependencies for this demo include AxCore and AxWebdriverJS. And AxWebdriverJS is sort of a bridge between AxCore and Selenium WebDriver. And then Jasmine is our chosen test framework for today. In our test, we have an existing integration test already set up for this radio button demo, and it tests that custom HTML radio button example that uses aria, just to make sure that when you tab onto it with the keyboard, if you hit the space key, that it will actually change its state, so change aria check to true. And that test is already passing, so if we were going to integrate AxCore with this, well, the first thing we need to do is go install our dependencies. So if I go over to the command line and run npm install, okay, now that we have our dependencies installed, we should go over to our test file and get things going over there. So I have an existing test file that has an integration test and all of the setup for a Selenium WebDriver. In the before each, it creates a new builder instance using the Chrome browser. And once we have a hold of that build in a driver variable, we can tell it to get a URL of localhost. So I'm checking this against localhost port 4000/radio running on my local machine. When that's done, it returns a promise, and we can reuse this for each test. And that it also hinges on the fact that after each test, we tell the driver to quit and then return a promise as well. That way, it will open each time fresh with all of the state reset. Our existing integration test checks the aria version of the radio button demo and just ensures that you can tab onto those spans and then using the space key actually engage one of those custom radio buttons. It's a good thing to do whenever you're recreating something that the browser would otherwise give you for free, as is the case with a native radio button. Since you're recreating that behavior with aria, you want to make sure that you have test coverage for it. Now to add AX to this, we're first going to create an AX builder variable and require AX WebdriverJS. And that will add it to our dependencies in this test file. So now I can add a test, which I'm going to paste to save some time. And this checks that it should fetch the radio button demo and analyze it. It will take that driver instance that we created above. After it gets that same URL, we'll check that we're on the right page by using Selenium Spy CSS Finder to check for a radio or a radio class. And then when that returns that promise, we can use the AX builder, which is a singleton, pass it the Selenium driver web driver instance, and run the analyze method. That analyze method takes a callback function, which we can use to pass through the results object that AX and AX WebdriverJS will return. So what that check has actually found by running accessibility tests against that web page. And we've got a couple of handy things in here, starting with a console log statement, just to make sure that we know that this test ran, because sometimes if there are no violations, you aren't sure if it really ran. And that just dynamically appends the number of violations, just to say if there were any, whether or not it failed. And then if there are more than zero violations, for development purposes, I'm console logging out the results.violations object. Using the node utilita inspect method, I can console out a pretty verbose tree, including some HTML that'll help me debug this problem. And then I expect that there should be no violations, so that results.violations.length should be zero, because we don't want any accessibility failures. So I'm going to save that, and I'm going to go over to our tests, and I'm going to run npm test. Uh-oh, there was a failure. So it found a problem with the custom radio button demo, in that although it has all of the things you would need for a custom radio button, including a roll of radio and aria labeled by and a tab index of zero, it found that there was a missing aria attribute. It's required to have aria dash checked of false by default. And so I guess although it is checked after you interact with it, which is what our existing integration test was checking, it did not set it by default. So to fix that, I'm going to go over to this jQuery custom radio group file, which is handling the aria for that demo. So I'm on the hunt for a role of radio, not a radio group because that's the parent, but I scroll down and I can find there's a handle for me to add an attribute. So I'm going to just add an attribute, aria checked, and I'll give it false because that's what the default value should be for those radio buttons. So now if I go back to my test and I run npm test again, we can see that there are now zero accessibility violations. So that's how we've gone from a failing test to passing tests. And I, as a developer, can feel comfortable that I have test coverage for accessibility in my project, and that AxCore has made it so I don't have to write every single one of those accessibility checks myself. I don't have to keep up to date on what aria works in what browser. By pulling an AxCore through WebdriverJS, I can extend their test experience into my own project, which is really valuable.